Today, we will talk about the MediaMax control MAC layer, and more specifically about TSCH, the standardized MAC protocol for industrial IoT networks. I will start with an introduction, but due to time constraints, I will have to skip some details. The MAC is a sublayer of the data link layer specified in the 7-layer OSI model, and it provides addressing and channel access control mechanisms. The MAC sublayer adds the source address and destination addresses in the frame. Thus, the nodes are aware of whether or not they are the legitimate receivers of the received frame. Using a wireless medium, communications are broadcast by nature. This means that all the nodes that are within the propagation range of the transmitter can potentially hear a transmission. However, if several nodes transmit a frame at the same time over the same radio channel, there will be most likely be a collision, and the reception of the transmission as a result will be impossible. Therefore, the MAC sublayer proposes mechanisms to avoid multiple nodes that are within the propagation range transmitting at the same time and over the same radio channel. In fact, it includes protocols that regulate who has the right to talk, who should listen, and at what time. Thus, the numerous solutions that have been proposed so far aim at fairness in terms of channel access and/or throughput, reliability to guarantee the success of the transmissions, scalability, the potential to increase the size of a network, and latency, reducing the time of receiving a frame. Among all the solutions, we can particularly distinguish two families: random access and scheduled access. In random access or contention-based methods, distributed algorithms are employed where all nodes have an equal role. In particular, no node can permit or forbid another node from transmitting a frame. Random access methods are based on the following principle. When a node has a frame to send, it may listen to the radio channel, and if it is free, it will simply transmit its frame. If the transmission fails because, for example, another node had the same idea of transmitting a frame at the same time over the same radio channel, it will try again sometime later using a random delay. Some of the most popular random-based access protocols are Aloha, that is used in IoT for the LoRa technology, and CSMA, that is used in Wi-Fi. Let us talk about TSCH now, a scheduled access method that is defined in IEEE 802.15.4 as well as in other technologies. So in 2016, the IEEE 802.15.4 2015 standard was published to offer a certain level of quality of service for industrial applications. Among the operating modes defined in the standard, time-slotted channel hopping TSCH was introduced. TSCH comes with 16 radio channels operating at 2.4 GHz. Each radio channel has a bandwidth of 2 MHz and a channel separation of 5 MHz. There are two main principles here. We have the time-slotted concept, where the continuous time is divided into time slots, and a given node will be assigned a time slot at which it can send or receive a frame. The second is the channel hopping mechanism, where the use of multiple radio channels allows the nodes to hop from one radio channel to another. Moreover, it allows for two distinct sources to send a frame at the same time to two different destinations. Let's see this in more detail. In a TSCH network, all nodes continuously synchronize themselves on a periodic slot frame. This slot frame is a frame that repeats in time for the whole duration of the network. It divides the time into time slots of equal length. In each time slot, there is enough time to transmit a frame and receive its acknowledgement. If the acknowledgement is not received within the duration of the time slot, the transmission is considered as failed, and a retransmission will be postponed to the next available dedicated time slot. At each time slot, each node knows if it has the right to send a frame. It needs to stay awake to receive a frame, and it can sleep to save energy because there will be no traffic that concerns it. Furthermore, for a given pair of nodes, transmitter and receiver, a specific time slot and channel offset is assigned, called a cell. Let us see an example. In this schedule, where we represent the time in the x-axis and the channel offset in the y-axis, we can see the allocated cells. For instance, in time slot 1, we see that a node has an allocated cell to send a frame to node B on channel offset 0. And at the same time slot, node F has a cell to send a frame to node S on channel offset 1. TSCH is thus very efficient because it avoids collisions and allows predicting the delay to access the channel. However, there are downsides also. Nodes need to be synchronized, which is not always straightforward and may be costly in terms of time and energy. The schedule, that is to say the way the slot frame is defined, may be hard to construct if the network comes with a variable traffic or with dynamic topology. Regarding the construction and the distribution of the schedule, in case the schedule is built by a central node, then the distribution of the schedule to all the nodes can be a challenging task. Alternatively, nodes may directly negotiate with their neighbors which cell to use, which is also a time-consuming process. In any case, no solution comes for free. To conclude, we can say that TSCH is well adapted to periodic and stable traffic. So in many industrial applications where we need monitoring or control loops, TSCH is probably a good choice to provide end-to-end network reliability. Thank you for listening.